Welcome to the Kaiju Podcast. I'm Ralph.
I'm Jorge.
And today we are talking about Gamera 2, Attack of the Legion.
1996. But, oh, hey, I don't know if your version, mine, when the titles came up, It called it Advent of Legion.
Yeah, there's also Attack of Legion and something else of Legion. There's like a billion titles.
There's an assault one.
Yeah. But the one, yeah, it was weird because it had subtitles that said Attack of the Legion, but the
But the actual title itself said Advent of Legion, yeah. It's their Revenge of the Jedi.
Yeah, I ended up watching like half of one version. Like I was watching a subtitle version, and then I was having issues with it. And then I ended up watching like an English dub, which was easier to watch.
Right.
Because taking notes, it makes it easier.
Yeah, I did the thing when I have an option for both, I was watching English dub, but with the subtitles for the Japanese.
Yeah.
So I could see when the subtitles would kind of change or we'd get something a little different than what the English dub had.
Yeah. And I was afraid I was going to get two different things, but when I was scrubbing through the English dub, I noticed that a lot of the lines were the same, like verbatim. So I was like, okay, I should be good.
Yeah.
Well, right.
But there's some things they said in the English, like the English dub, there's a little bit more kind of vulgar language in it.
Yeah. Like, it's funny how they say things like shit. Like, they're really excited to say it.
Yeah.
And
that doesn't match the subtitle.
So the version I have kind of had some sort of glitches at the beginning. And so I'm like, okay, I'm going to watch the other one. And there was a part where they go in to save some miners and there's like these freeze frames or save some people in the subway. And I was like,
what's with the slideshow?
Yeah. And so I was like, oh, my thing is just keep on just getting messed up.
Just
so
spritzing.
And so when I went to check the other one, I'm like, oh, this was intended. So I was like, okay, I'm just going to watch this version. So Gamera 2 apparently is like a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
So leading up to this, a lot of people, when we made it past, I think it was Gamera Super Monster, the one where it was like all clips and it had the superwomen people were said, and we said we're gonna give it a break and we're gonna get into the 90s one. People were very excited and they're like, oh man, Gamera 2 is the best. I don't know if it was high expectations. I didn't think it was the best, but I gotta say it may have some of my favorite model work that I've seen in a long time. Some of the model work, it's amazing.
Yeah, well, when I was watching it, there's a whole section in the middle, the part that there's a lot of explanation going on where they're basically explaining what the creatures are and, you know, and all the different things, all their different plans and stuff. I was just having trouble following.
Yeah.
I then went and I read the synopsis and then I went back and I just kind of played segments of the middle and stuff over again and watched them a second time. And I actually enjoyed it more then. At first I'm like, what's going on with this monster? What are his back legs exactly? And it's like, is he donkey kicking at the beginning when he's underground? It's like, I was trying to figure out like how those legs worked exactly. His like, cause he's got like reverse cricket legs. And I was a bit like that, but then I was like, I really kind of got into the design of this guy. He's all over the place.
Yeah. What's nice about it is it's not the same one. It's not like, like last time we got a new version of Gauss. So this is like cool because it's like a new guy, but I feel like it's nice because it's like a totally original design. The head of it looks very much like the knife head in Pacific Rim.
I know it does. It like totally really does.
Looks like it. It does the opening like open split thing a lot, which was kind of cool. Yeah. But yeah, it's nice to have a unique design. I was afraid that these movies were just going to redo a lot of the, like after Gauss, seeing the redo of Gauss, that we're just going to see the redo of blank or whatever. But it was kind of cool.
I also liked a lot how this is such a direct sequel.
Yeah.
You meet like the guy who's a security guard who used to be the cop. The fact that, you know, it's like the way his story isn't much, but it they have this through line where,
yeah.
Oh, now he does his other job and stuff from what he used to do and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. That was cool.
So this Legion, it's a group of small creatures, and then there's a big one, right? It's not like Destroya where they come together.
Well, right. Well, it's a group of small creatures, a flower, and the...
Yeah, that was confusing. I thought the big one was going to be the... like more
from come out of the flower or something.
But yeah, and the flower reminded me of like the early stages of Biollante.
Yeah,
like it almost reminded me of the same prop, but I don't think it was.
No, I thought Biollante had more like a rose quality to her.
Yeah.
One of the subtitle differences when they go like when they pull up the car and she's like, "I'll have a look around." In English, yeah, it goes right, and the subtitle goes, "No, wait."
No.
It's just like little. That was the first one that I was like going, "Oh, that's interesting." Like it just changed like the different type of attitudes for you know, the dangers out there.
Yeah.
I like the little guys. I like the one eye. How they have one eye? It's very classic, like old school sci-fi to do like a cyclops.
Yeah. Yeah. I was trying to think of what they reminded me of, and I feel like something like from the Explorers or like Ice Pirates or something. Like it felt like that to me. And
you know, yeah, there's I was same thing. I, like the way what they refer to as the big one.
Uh-huh.
I like it. That's all they call it.
Yeah.
The big one. The big one. The small legs that are up around like the shell part.
Yeah, like the back.
The small legs reminded me of something. I texted you. It reminded me of something I've seen somewhere, but I don't know what it is.
You didn't figure out what it was?
No.
Yeah.
No, I don't. There's a part of me that feels like it might be caveman, but then I also think because of when we had that caveman conversation not that long ago, I was like, maybe I'm just forcing it into that.
Wait a second. I think I watched the caveman trailer after editing that episode, because that was like our last episode that we did, and maybe there's something like it in the trailer, like a flower or something that kind of looks
is
that.
It there's something, because like I remember there's something where some guy is on, like I remember laughing at it because I think it's a comedy sci-fi comedy where it's like someone is on this thing and these like legs basically attack him or whatever.
Yeah.
And he ends up a mess. Like he comes out, it looks like he's covered in mustard or something. And
are we
like, going
to have to watch Caveman?
I'm worried. for the show, for the podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was like, technically that's a big monster.
Yeah.
When the dinosaur shows up.
Yeah. And then farts or whatever it does. When the flower shows up,
the real kaiju came in is those turds.
Yeah. when the
flower shows up.
Yeah, there's like that model building collapsing. It looks really good. Like I did like it.
Really good. Like the composite of it with the people running around and stuff. It looked really good.
Yeah. I think what I like is that I feel like the Gamera movies, when they shoot their model stuff, they do it outside. So you get like natural light and it just has a more realistic look to it. Cause the Toho movies always seem to be on a soundstage with like a painted sky. But there's something really, it's like a natural light to this movie and the last Gamera movie. And I really like that. Cause that model was, I mean, I don't know what they used to build it, but it looked pretty cool. And there's
the parts. And the way it broke up was really good.
Yeah. Yeah, and there's like the attention to detail. Like there's some shots later on where you have like a fence in the foreground with like barbed wire, and it looks like the details look realistic, and they're shot from like realistic angles. And it makes me want a kaiju movie now with models.
Oh.
Like it makes me want to see
Yeah, I wish.
what someone could do now. And like Shin Godzilla looked great. Like there's some points where we're like, is this a model or is it like is it a guy in a suit or not? But it definitely wasn't models. It was like CG. But I'm just
Yeah.
wondering if this is the type of model building they could do in, 1996. I'd love to see what they could do now.
Yeah, I just don't know if they do it. I just think it's kind of a lost art in a way, because it's so much easier to build a building out of CGI. And when they do it with stuff like buildings, you don't notice it because they don't have to animate them, they don't have to move them. So then it's so easy to just kind of like be. It isn't until they have to do something like make it explode that you go, oh, that's fake.
But they did, but it looked really good on this one. I thought all the building destruction looked really good.
Yeah.
It's, I mean, I just wish it continued on. I guess we do have building stuff like after this with like the Millennia series and Godzilla and stuff. But even then they would start to resort to the comp shots where the creature was behind the live action buildings.
Yeah, that was such. Yeah, I think that was just because it was the technology that was the hot thing at the time, I guess, and it's made it easy. This was bloody, like the all the humans getting dead, like big splats of blood on
Oh,
windows and stuff like
that
that.
dude's the dude's blood like hitting the window and his hand splatting on it.
Yeah. I mean, I was like, this is some serious violent and death stuff going on in this one.
I like the little creatures were filled
Yeah.
with compressed air.
Gas.
Yeah, it was like a
Oxygen.
yeah, they're like a hydraulic based
Right.
at
That's instead of muscles, they move by hydraulics.
Yeah, I thought that was a really cool idea, and I like that when they got shot, they would like the gas would shoot out of the holes.
Yeah.
I like that they weren't like indestructible. There was just a bunch of them. Did
Yeah,
you?
I liked when like they were on that neon sign, and then the one drops in the bush, so you kind of get a good kind of like size idea on them, and then also yeah, when there's like the autopsy and there's the table with them, and then he pops it open.
Did you watch it on? You have like a Blu-ray of this?
Yeah.
Do you watch it on the Blu-ray?
Yeah.
Okay, because I watched it on a like a DVD rip, and the swarm looked cool, but I think mine was a little blurry. I'm assuming it was CG. Like, how did the
Yeah, it
swarm of
was.
Legion look for yours? Did it look all right? It looked better
It
than
looks. It looks CG.
the. Yeah, it
It
looked.
looked. It looks CG, especially like when they jump on top of Gamera.
Did it look better
It's
than the
kind of
dolphins?
the dolphins.
It's like when Gamera first shows up, he's like swimming underwater and there's like a bunch of dolphins swimming.
No, I think the dolphins actually might have looked better.
Okay. So yeah, like I checked it off. The 30-minute mark, we get Gamera in the UFO form, which was fun. The spinning one.
Yeah.
But we have a new way of Gamera flying.
It's awesome.
I
That
loved it.
the T form Gamera flight is great, and the landing, and then the wing retraction thing where he goes and he sucks his wings in. I was like, "Whoa, look at these."
I thought that was impressive. I thought it looked cool. It looked cool, way cooler than when his just hands are out. Like it made more sense to me. Like it just looked, I loved it. It was probably my favorite thing was the like sea turtle wings, and then they like kind of sucked in and into the hands, but it looks so much like it just looks like a fighter jet, And when he's got the hands out the front, like in every other one that we've seen, it just looks so much sillier. I'm assuming they have action figures or vinyl figures of this style of Gamera.
Of that shape?
Yeah, they have to, right? Because I think if I were to get a Gamera, it would be like that dude. Because that thing is cool. I really, like, that was the thing for me. Because I'm a big fan of, like, flying kaiju, but the Gamera flying kaiju has never really impressed me. But this is, like, something, like, completely different. It's not just, you know, we complain, like, that, like, a standing kaiju looks the same, or when they turn into a flying kaiju, they just kind of have a rigid model of it. But it's kind of cool that it has a transforming quality. I don't know. I thought it was rad. I loved it. It's my favorite thing in this movie is that flying Gamera.
Oh yeah, it does exist.
Yeah, I figured it's cool. Another thing with the model building is that we got a rare model building, but that was an interior, the shopping mall. Like, we don't see that a lot. I'm assuming it was a model when the shopping mall collapses.
Mm-hmm.
I like that a lot. Because usually when buildings collapse, you just see it from the outside. Or they might cut to an interior of a mall set and just like drop like styrofoam ceiling and stuff.
Yeah.
But this was like a model of a interior of a mall. And it looked really good too. I think it was Black Scorpion, where we got something kind of like that, where it was like a house was shaking and collapsing, and then
the whole thing fell apart. Yeah, totally.
Yeah, so I like that too. Like, I think as far as like the monster stuff goes, like this is some like top notch stuff. I think this movie lacks story wise.
Yeah,
but I could see why it's people's favorite. Because it is bloody. Like, Gamera gets messed up.
Oh, yeah. He gets, like, a chunk.
Yeah.
Like, a chunk gets cut out of his shell.
And then he's just, like, spurting, like, green blood everywhere. Which is kind of stuff that happened in the older ones. Like the original ones.
Yeah.
Where we'd see, like, Gamera just, like, laying in the water. Just, like, blood spewing out of him. Or Gauss getting chopped up by Gyron.
Right.
Just all the, like, the purple blood.
Yeah, this just made it seem.
Which is funny because it's like, is it still a kids movie? Or they're taking it more serious.
They definitely seem to tone down the kids part.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah. Maybe it's just made for people who grew up with the original Gamera. Like, it's like.
The kids that are now adults.
Yeah, yeah. But, I mean. I don't care. Like, I'm not like, I'm fine with all the blood and stuff. I think the swearing is silly. It always seems out of place. Like, in all of these movies or in like Godzilla movies, like, even if it's like a deadly serious Godzilla movie, it always just seems out of place. But
there was the camera, the, like, where every step was like an explosion.
Yeah.
In the snow.
Mm-hmm.
That was cool.
Yeah. There was also a part where, was it Gamera burrowing? Or no, it was Legion burrowing. I'm just calling the big one Legion. And it's like the Duke just kind of goes down and you just see the dirt like pulsing like as it like digs farther and farther deeper. But it's just like a boom, 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 boom. Like, there's a lot of cool effects work as well. Like, as cool as the models were, like, I think all the like sort of explosions and dust and all of that sort of like environment changing stuff like was really top notch too. I watched
another hold on. Okay. You know when the two men are on the computer.
Uh-huh.
or when she has to get up and she has to leave because she's gonna go. I think it's when she goes to the autopsy.
Uh-huh.
And the two men are stuck with the computer, but they don't know. Oh, because there's the Gamera blog that they're looking at.
Oh, he's got his own website.
Yeah, and they're like, And they're like, oh, I don't know how to read English, but you know, they're nervous. And then the website like shrinks, like it kind of folds up like a piece of paper. You remember that?
Yeah.
And so in the Japanese, the subtitle says, "Don't just groan." And the English dub is, "Don't be a bitch, do something."
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that was bizarre. When you watched this before I did, and you told me that you asked if I had watched it, if it was confusing, if he's like, "Oh, there's something I need to look up about the middle." And so I kept waiting like for the in the middle section to be like, "I'm wondering what he's looking up." And the only thing I could think of was you were looking up, is there really man boy bathhouses? Because no, that was weird.
No. This was just like,
stuff.
I was missing bits of the explanations.
Yeah.
Of, you know, how they were explaining, like, the leaf cutter ant analogy on how that they use the fungus and blah, 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 you know, to explain the plant with the legion and all those different little bits and how, like, trying to figure out, so wait, now it's launching the seed and that's going to do all this, all those things. And yeah, just kind of following all that. Cause there's like a whole chunk in the middle where they kind of explain everything and why it's important.
Yeah. Cause I was watching it and I was kind of following, but I was looking for something really confusing. And then that scene showed up. I'm like, that's pretty confusing. I don't understand why we're seeing this. Cause there's like naked dudes. There's like, it was like the locker room of like a YMCA or something. But I'm like, oh my gosh, am I going to see dudes wieners in this movie? But I don't think I did.
Yeah. You would not be so lucky.
It was bizarre. I did write down this note and it kind of made me laugh. The like general guy, was at like the headquarters or whatever. And he comes out of the office into a hallway where there's just a bunch of hats.
All the hats?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he grabs one and puts it on. And my first thought was, does he know that's his hat? Or is it just a free-for-all? You just kind of grab one.
Yeah, everyone gets a hat. Yeah. I was thinking the same thing with it. Because it's so many hats.
It's, dude, there's so many hats.
More hats than there are people in that room that he came out of.
Yeah. So that's what made me think. I'm like, oh, you just kind of grab one. Like, it's for everybody.
Right. Yeah, they're arranged by size. He knows which peg is.
Yeah.
That was very funny. There's no one else. There's no one in the hallway. It's just him and her.
Yeah.
And all those hats. It's like, listen, we can't afford all these background actors, but we have a bunch of hats.
Yeah, it seemed like it was a real place.
Yeah.
Like, and I don't know how that works. Did it seem like there was like quick shots of like stop motion during some of the fights, like during some of the little guys?
I didn't notice stop motion.
Yeah, it could have been just maybe weird CG or something. But
I mean, there's a lot of puppeteering and puppeteering and costume work.
Right. Right.
But I don't remember stop motion.
I thought it was funny that both monsters had hidden powers.
Oh, surprises?
Yeah. Including Gamera, who we've seen in like, I don't know, eight or movies.
This is a souped up Gamera. He's got his wing system and we know he can shoot fire or fireballs out of his
mouth.
And the big finish fireball?
Yeah. Like that's something where it's like he could have probably used that sooner in this movie.
Yeah,
let alone any other movie.
Classic. That's classic. like, you know, the thing that they do in any of these kind of movies with giant robots or giant monsters, that they like to bury the lead.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Like if you have a giant, you have a giant robot, you don't pull the special sword yet until you know, the time is right.
Right. But his Gamera's, that was nuts.
Yeah.
I didn't hate it.
The way the Legion's like, hey, look at this thing opens up and I shoot you with my Blu-ray. And then Gamera's like, oh, I have a thing that opens up too.
Apparently. I don't hate it, but there's nothing that let me know that this is a possibility ever.
No.
And ever since we started this show, like, this has never been a possibility.
Yeah, that his shell would open up?
Yeah. Like, I can understand if maybe he started shooting, like, something out of his leg holes or something, or his arm holes, because we've seen fire come out of that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, has he ever done, used his jet propulsion as a weapon? Like, suck his arm in and then just burn someone with, like, his jets?
I feel like we've seen a guy grab him, and then he sucked his arms in, and then flew the other guy far away.
Oh, okay.
Like, I think they did that to, who was the kind of silver swordfish-looking guy?
Yeah.
Not Jiger.
Gyron? Gyron?
Gyron was the knife guy. Oh. Remember, he flew up.
Okay, sword versus knife.
The guy who got stuck. Yeah, he played the xylophone on his back before he killed him. He was like a flying. He was like a flying fish. No, that's Virus.
Oh man, we've seen too many of these.
But it was a oh fuck! It was like right before the super monster. It was like the last like decent one. And he was like a flying fish with a swordfish face, and he was silver. And Gamera plays his spines like a xylophone before it kills him.
I remember him doing that.
Yeah, but there was like a point where I think Gamera grabs him and then fires off the rockets to take him into the sky. I think, I don't remember. They're all blurring. But I don't think he's used those to like shoot somebody. But I feel like
burn them.
Yeah, I feel like that would be like something where I'm like, oh, that's a cool use of that thing we've seen 100 times. But this is like flat out, hey, look at this now. I'm like, oh shit. I mean, okay, cool. I guess I liked it. It reminded me of like Iron Man when Iron Man does that, he shoots out of his chest. Or I think Mogera does something similar to that, where his chest opens up and fires like a black hole gun or something.
Zegra. Yeah.
That's a bad name for that creature.
Yeah, because you want him to be a part tiger, part zebra.
Yeah. Not a swordfish.
Not a fish.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of like, or like the Star Wars movie where with the new lightsaber that's got the sides that shoot out.
Yeah.
And when he pushes it up against his shoulder.
Yeah.
I'm using this. Yeah. Yeah, as my note. Big Legion creature is cool. I don't get what his back legs are doing. Oh, I like it. Okay. So then Gamera goes into suspended animation.
Yeah.
Or whatever, you know. It's his pre spinach Popeye moment.
Yeah.
Where you like, oh no, what's gonna happen? And there's like all the people who are like having like a vigil at Gamera's body, and there's that mom that's like telling the kid like, don't worry, he's just sleeping. Oh god, how do I explain to my kid that Gamera's dead?
This happens a lot, right? Like Gamera, it's like part of. Like Gamera lore is he needs to. There's that one time where he turned into like a see-through skeleton and was laying on the bottom of the ocean, and his foot was sticking out. In that other one where he's at the bottom of the ocean, like he seems like he has to die before.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'd go to a Gamera vigil. I think that would be, I mean, because I want to get, I would get, like, if this was real, which it's not, but I would want to get close enough to a kaiju to see it.
It's not, okay. Go on. If this is real, but it's not. No. Continue.
But I would like, I would go, I would want to get real close to Gamera and check it out.
Only because you knew Gamera was safe.
Yeah, and apparently dead, even though me knowing what I know, know he's going to come back. But,
right.
Yeah, because we've talked about it before. Like, if there was a real kaiju, how close would you get
right.
to want to look at it? And
yeah,
but a dead one, yeah, we're I'm there. It's weird, morbid, but true, I think. And plus, it's Gamera. I think Gamera's not very threatening.
No, he seems to make it very clear that he's like, as opposed to like when Godzilla helps mankind, it's like he kind of ignores us.
Yeah.
As much as he can. But Gamera's like, hey, I'm here for you.
Yeah.
You know, he keeps, like, making eye contact with us.
Because he's like the...
Or the girl who has her magic bean.
Yeah. I'm fresh out of notes.
Oh. Okay, so... this is funny because there's been enough time since I saw it that I'm reading my notes and I'm like, what is front mouth things like punching puppets?
Okay.
I know what it means. Do you think you can decipher it?
I remember punching puppets, like the one you would blow up and it would be like a clown.
No. You know, the ones that are like, nun.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And you
yeah.
pull the levers on the back and they extend puppets. Their arms out.
Yeah, puppets, not punching bags. I know those. Like, I remember, like, when I was a kid, I would do an impression of that a lot. It was one of my favorite things to do.
Yeah, so that, there's, like, that part in the movie, like, that, like in the big one, he's got those two little things that are, like, kind of like part of his mouth. It's like, I guess, in nature, an animal would use those to maybe to draw the food into the mouth.
Okay.
You know, he's got those like little mini arm things.
Yeah,
on.
Yeah.
Her beak exploded.
Well, they kept opening it up and shooting that beam. Like, they figured out how to make that operate, and they wanted to use it as much as they could.
Yeah, and so then Gamera breaks the point off.
And like busted in two, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He breaks it. And his eyes change color. They become the big one's eyes go red.
Yeah.
And then the big one has basically it's like a new weapon.
Something.
The licorice whip.
Yeah, the red vines. No, not red vines. What was the really long one that you like get at like baseball
licorice
games?
Licorice whip. Wasn't it licorice whip?
Is that what
licorice
it was?
Licorice whip.
Ooh, those taste so good. What it was called. Yeah, I like those.
There's like the ones that were super skinny. It's like there was
for an animated
licorice whip. Okay. Wasn't licorice whip? I think was a thing in like the old Batman series. I think like there's like a Candyman type of character, and when he was mad at his henchman, he was a licorice whip, or there's something where some Candyman guy he would call for the licorice whip, and they had to give him licorice whip, and he would whip them with it.
Maybe it's so, from. Yeah, maybe it's from Caveman.
Oh.
I'm not huge into, like, the animated powers. I mean, I guess we get animated fire from, like, Godzilla and stuff. But I thought those whips looked really cool. The way they were animated and the way they kind of stuck through Gamera and the animation was able to, like, track his body so... They look like they were actually stuck in there. I don't know if they used like some sort of real sort of
And then rope animate over
and then
it.
Animated over
like,
it.
Like the broomstick.
Yeah. But it was... But I thought it looked... For that kind of effect, I thought it looked really cool. Because I'm usually I don't have any sort of I don't really care about sort of the animated stuff. We're more I think you're the same. We're more about the practical stuff.
Right.
But I thought for an animated thing, it looked kind of cool. I thought it was well done.
The other interesting thing in the mythology is how they're attracted to like electromagnetic energies or whatever.
Yeah, and the,
like that was the other thing that one of the things I had to like get had to watch again to figure out the whole bit where they even did that shot where it's almost like the infrared type of view of the creatures looking at the people in the subway, and they're picking up their portable phones and computers or whatever electronics that give off that kind of signal. And those are the people that got attacked, and the other ones were spared. And then later, when there's like the they kind of like help Gamera by turning on all like that electricity.
Mm-hmm.
And stuff so that
the little ones
yeah. get stuck on that thing. I was hoping that like, was cool. What I wanted is I wanted it to be like I wanted them to like fry like they were on one of those zapper things.
Oh yeah,
that like kill like mosquitoes.
Yeah.
When they shoot the big one with the missiles is pretty good. Like some of the arms get broken off. I think that's pretty cool.
The good damage, good monster damage in this.
Yeah, definitely.
And to Gamera as well, just the way he would get like cuts and stuff.
Sometimes, like these Gamera eyes are interesting. They're rounder than like the old school eyes from but it's funny. Like when he moves, sometimes the Gamera moves, and you see like the eyes move around it. It's such a like a doll kind of.
Yeah. They just kind of slide back and forth. I like the Gamera suit. When he was walking around. I like this Gamera
suit a lot.
Yeah. This is another one. Like I've seen like the Bandai type toys of this where he's in like the pose where he's got like the foot forward and he's like got both hands out and stuff.
Chunky, big, his big base feet.
Yeah. It's like sharp angles and sharp points and not real cutesy.
Yeah, the suit damage, also the way like Gamera has all his cuts all over his body.
Yeah,
it's good. The fights are really good.
I feel like this is a top, like I know people online are like, this is the one, but yeah,
this is my thing though. It's like these reboots of Gamera are interesting, but they are definitely. It's like I feel like the newer Godzillas, it's still Godzilla.
Yeah.
But the old Gameras were so child oriented. Yeah. There was so much about how, that the kids would yell stuff to Gamera. Gamera would hear them and react accordingly. That there's this very specific, and here Gamera's kind of forgotten the children. He kind of helps all mankind, and so I mean these are cool. He looks cooler than he did back then. It's just it's a more modern Gamera, but it's. But I do. I never thought I'd say it, but I go. I kind of miss the stupid kid stuff.
Yeah, I do too. It's like the difference between watching like say, like 66 Batman and like Nolan's Dark Knight. Like they're just completely it's the same character, but it's like completely different feel. The thing is though, like this is the 90s, and the way Japan did 90s kids movies was the Mothra series.
Right.
I don't think I could handle that.
I would have wanted to see Gamera take that route.
Yeah. But I feel like there's got to be some sort of middle ground. Because I think... I don't know. It's tough. So, I don't know.
Oh, man. Because I was... I started just putting on in the background just to look at a part, and then I just got to the part where the shell opens up and he gives that super blast.
Yeah.
And it's so funny how each segment of the shell opens up. it's like each little bit opens up, and it's just a long blast too. It takes forever.
It's weird. It's weird. But I like it. But it's weird. It's like Shin Godzilla.
You think they'd bring it back? You think they'd bring it back?
Like in the next one?
No, I meant like a Gamera for the 2020s.
I would like it.
I'd be really interested in seeing it. It would be. But I would be interesting as to what would happen. What
I feel like
someone would visit and do.
I feel like if you did Gamera now, if you skewed it more towards a younger audience, you can get away with keeping it as a guy in a suit. And if you're going for a more adult audience, they would do CG.
I can't think of... well, it would be cool. Like, the thing they did in Shin with the CG actor with the weighted tail thing.
Yeah.
Really made it look like a guy in a suit. Got him to move like a guy in a suit, and that was cool.
Yeah, if they could do that with this. I mean, absolutely. Yes, I want to see that.
Obviously, we'd see it. We'd see it, but it's just like...
What would it be? Like, what would the next evolution? Because it has been, like, I think...
What would you do?
So, I think it's been 13 years since the last Gamera movie. So, it's like... what would be next? Like, there seems to be these big gaps in between.
Oh, yeah, Gamera I forget. Because, like... There's more after this, the one that comes after this one.
Yeah. We have one more in this trilogy.
Trilogy.
And then there's like there's like a 10-year gap or something.
But that Gamera definitely looks like a kid's movie.
Yeah. But I mean, I think it's still a puppet or a man in a suit.
Oh, it is? Because it looks.
I don't know. I don't know. But we'll see. But I think, whatever they would do, I'm sure we'd see it.
Well, like, we know that. Yeah, we know we'd see it. I was like, I wonder, yeah.
But, I mean...
Because, like, also, these three were distributed by Toho.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, that's interesting, seeing the Toho logo come up at the beginning.
Yeah.
And just like, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, or if an American company would be like, oh, we want to bring back Gamera. And what would they, you know, legendary Gamera.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know if, like, the Godzillas and Skull Islands and all these things are, like, if they just exploded, we would definitely see a Gamera. That would be the one that they would do. But I don't know if they're popular enough.
That they're making enough money to just make people go crazy.
Yeah. But I feel like.
What about Shin? Did Shin do enough in Japan and world markets to make them go, oh, what else are we going to do?
I have no idea.
Wonder.
Yeah. But, yeah, and I don't know if there's anything happening after Godzilla versus King Kong.
Mm.
We'll see. But. Because, yeah, around the time we started doing this, it was weird how all of a sudden there's, like, Pacific Rim 2 and Rampage and Colossal and, like,
yeah.
Like those didn't exist since, like, I don't know, Cloverfield, which was, what, 2008?
Right, that's right.
So it's, like, weird that it, like, kind of, yeah, I don't know.
You kind of got excited, like going, oh, it'd be great if this ends up being like Marvel superhero movies.
Yeah.
Where they just like, they make so many that people get sick of them. But
We'll see.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna hit that.
Yeah, I don't think we'll get the Gamera. If we're lucky, Godzilla versus Kong will do really well, and then they'll do, I'm assuming, would be Mecha Godzilla after that.
Wow.
Because the way, like, King of the Monsters was set up, where they had that big, like, that big bunker where it was like 10 miles
Yeah, the
deep,
thing is,
and
like, I feel like they have to, like, you feel like the next one has to be kind of in production before they even know the success of the one before it.
yeah, I
I
don't
feel like
know.
they would somehow like do like Godzilla versus King Kong 2 before they did a Mechagodzilla. I feel like that might feel like it's a further stretch to have people
Yeah.
come.
But the way they have like Monarch with their flying airships and stuff, and they have those big, huge facilities, like I feel like they could be ready to go by the next movie. But we'll see.
I mean, I'd love it. I'd love like an elevator going up and
Yeah.
just,
See like the profile as you go
yeah,
up.
I'd love
Yeah.
that.
All right. Top five? Probably not. Yeah, it's
No.
tough, man. I mean, something's gonna have to really blow our socks off. But I liked it.
Hard to crack.
Yeah,
It's
I
hard to
liked it a lot. I don't think I liked it as much as the internet would tell me I should like it. But like anytime there's a monster on screen, it was great. And then it's just the rest
Yeah.
of it was a little confusing and not terribly entertaining. But I mean, Flying Gamera, that was the best. Yeah, there's always just something that kind of tickles me like the right way, where it's just like, oh, that's really funny. Like it's goofy, but it looks badass to me.
It
Yeah.
looked cool. Yeah, the way like the jet propulsion stuff coming out of the back, and he in the bank turn. And yeah, it was just so, but still, when he lands and just and he retracts his
Yeah.
wings, it's just so like that's like his the Fonz move.
Hey. All right. One next episode. Let's talk about next episode. We're watching the giant behemoth. I'm not sure what the year is. I think 58 or no. I don't remember. I don't remember what the
Oh
year is.
yeah, it's
It's the
been
giant
so.
behemoth. I don't think there's any other movies called that.
It's a black and white
Yeah.
age.
So look forward to that. You'll should be able to watch it on kaijupod.com, where you also get links to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. And then, yeah,
1959.
1959. That was a year off. From the director of Gorgo, I believe. Same director as Gorgo, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, check that out. And until next time, I'm gonna go to this
Oh.
Gamera vigil.
Until next time,
I was gonna say something about the
I'm
bathhouse, but
going.
decided against
Oh
it.
boy.
Too many naked dudes in front of boys is does I
Oh,
not.
did you notice that one of the news reporter was called Mr. Miyagi?
No, I
By the
didn't.
way. Yeah. But he didn't look like Mr. Miyagi. So I guess it's just he just was a real Mr. Miyagi. I don't know. I'm just gonna. I'm gonna ask the lion and find the booze behind the hidden bookcase.
Oh, ask the lion. Like that immediately tipped off of what exactly they should do to open up the thing.
Yeah.
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 That was funny. All right, let's get out of here. That's cool.
All right, cool.
All right.